Madam President, nice to see you in the chair, and I hope, like other colleagues, to see a bit more of you. It is difficult to think of a more textbook case of a repressive regime than that in Uzbekistan. That beautiful country with the ancient cities of the Silk Road is treated more or less as the personal property of the president's family and some of their cronies. We have an almost Caligulan tyranny there, which is involved with drug running, with repression. Two opponents of the regime were boiled to death inside a prison. And yet, the West has tended to hold back from criticism because in the uncertain days immediately after 9/11, the Karimov dictatorship had the wit to declare itself an ally in the war on terror and to make available bases for use in the Afghan campaign. This is the error we make again and again in Muslim countries. We made it with the Shah in Iran. We've made it in Egypt. We're making it in Saudi Arabia. There is no fundamentalism, or very little, in Uzbekistan. The traveller there doesn't see beards, doesn't hear, see headscarves, doesn't hear the call to prayer. But if we define every opponent of the Karimov tyranny as a fundamentalist, eventually we will make that prediction come true, and we will create the very thing we purport to fear.